Eric Bakker, thanks for coming back. Irritable bowel syndrome. I think something like not between 9 to 11% of the population in the Western world suffer from IBS. So new studies have been conducted actually at Flinders University in Adelaide, Australia. Adelaide's a great place. I've been there a few times. I really like it there. But it can get really hot in summertime, you know, like 40-something, you know, like 103, 105 degrees or whatever. So crazy hot, but a beautiful place. So I've worked with IBS patients now for many, many years. Some of them experience abdominal pain, in fact, so bad it's debilitating that they can barely work, they can barely move. Not all irritable bowel syndrome patients will have abdo pain, but many do, and it can range from mild to incapacitating. But this professor at Flinders University conducted some research and found some really amazing stuff. They found that many people, for example, get itchy skin. And there are certain receptors on your skin that some people can have that can be far more troublesome, for example, those receptors in other people. Some patients I've seen always complain about itchy skin and they can't work out why or whether it's personal care products or things like that. And some people are just prone to skin problems in general. So what this doctor found through research was that in the small bowel of people with IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, they've got these sort of like itch receptors that really play up, that cause a problem, and these can trigger the pain. So these receptors have become very, very touchy and trigger happy with different people, but research is still ongoing to find out what really affects these receptors, what causes that itch receptor to stimulate the neurons. But when a person's had IBS for many years, they start getting a reconfiguration of the neuronal pathway. So their gut becomes sort of like wired a little bit differently from a normal gut because of this ongoing neuronal stimulation. But from where I'm sitting, I call IBS a garbage can diagnosis, as you know. Go and look at my playlist on irritable bowel syndrome. There's a few videos there. I'm sure I've done plenty on inflammatory bowel disease as well. So IBS is very common and there are many causes. So we can't just say that it's these neurons that are causing this problem. But what the hell's causing the neuron to have the problem? Every time I've looked at small intestinal bowel tests of these patients or comprehensive stool analysis and IBS, I find stuff. I find bacteria. I find yeast. I find parasites. I find stuff in that environment that shouldn't be there. Now, that can be for a few reasons. That can be because the person took medications to calm the gut down. They may have taken a proton pump drug for the stomach. They could have taken a motility drug. They could have taken a drug for hemorrhoids or for constipation or diarrhea or stuff like that. So medications could have caused that. But what I always say to people is get a comprehensive analysis of your GI tract by your gastroenterologist, but then also get some stool testing done by an alternative medicine professional, someone like I used to be because I'm going out of the clinic now. But see someone who can do a proper testing of your gut to determine if there are any overgrowth there. Small intestinal fungal overgrowth, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, colonic issues. It'll all come out with a test. My recommendation is to treat that first. Get the diet sorted, clean up the gut, work on the stress, then let's see where the abdo pain is. Because when I read this study that was done, they're saying, now we've got a new thing, now we've got this new novel approach. We're looking at all these new drugs now that we can target the gut with. And the doctor quickly added, but we're not going to use opioid drugs. No, of course not, because it just gives people another route to make money, sell more drugs. The opioid crisis is out of control. I was just reading in Scotland how many thousands of people are dying on these horrible drugs, drug-related overdoses. And we got the same in New Zealand. We got the same in Australia, same in America. Why do we keep inventing new drugs and bring more poisons out for people when we should be looking at causes instead of just these drug treatments? It's beyond me. I can't understand why we're not looking more at causes instead of just throwing band-aids at people. So if you have got irritable bowel syndrome, find the cause. And if you can't find the cause, maybe you can mitigate the symptoms, But over time, most IBS patients I've worked with have had a significant reduction in all symptoms, and in some cases, a total resolution. It is not a condition that you can cure, but you can mitigate a lot of the symptoms you have. and lead a normal life like a normal person, right? So be wary of these like studies, okay? Because sometimes when I read these studies, you always read down the bottom, you know, sponsored by AYZ company or something. So it makes you wonder who's funding these studies, what's behind it, right? Remember, many companies that produce medications now are being bashed around the head so much because, you know, we know now a lot of medications cause problems with people. So they're always finding new novel drugs to come out with and saying, hey, this one's okay. It doesn't cause any problem until 2 or 3 years down the track. Then it all comes out. Look at the cause. Identify it. Treat it. Makes a big difference. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget the link if you want my free Candida report. It's in the description box. Thank you.